Industrials and energy are the weak link here. 4-1 declining to advancing stocks, although we are still off the low. It's not bad given the rally we had on Thursday and Friday. Take a look at sectors. It's kind of defensive tone, not surprisingly. Utilities were up at the open. Consumer staples doing a little bit better. Banks are holding up okay. Energy's down because oil's down a dollar. And Halliburton's guidance on the conference call, a little shaky there, and I think that might be a little bit of an issue. Industrials are weak, as you saw, some of the big trade names are weak. But also, we've got some weakness in some of these names here. That Stanley Black & Decker guidance was really rather poor, and it's affecting related industries to Stanley Black & Decker. Obviously, Masco, for example, or Snap-on, United Rentals. Related sectors all down 3 or 4%. Take a look at the market risks right now and the things that are out there that we're all dealing with. In terms of the shutdown, I think it's been remarkable. I think the markets have been very, very patient. I saw a lot of ancillary stories over the weekend about employees of government contractors being laid off. They are not government employees. They're employees of government contractors. These are private people. That's now starting to ripple through. China's slowing. We had the GDP, 6%. Lowest GDP since 1990 for 2018. So that's sort of priced into the market. They're still doing a lot of stimulus there. Brexit's a big wild card. And the trade talk deal, I know it was a long time ago, folks, Thursday and Friday. Let me just show you the S&P 500. We moved 50 points on the S&P, 500 points on the Dow Jones Industrial Average. Put that chart up on Thursday and Friday, all on trade talk optimism. There it is. That's a two-day chart of the S&P. That was quite a rally here. So we are vulnerable to either no deal or even potentially sell on the news. We've priced a lot of trade talk optimism into the markets right now. Let's turn to earnings. Remember Mike Wilson from Morgan Stanley got a lot of kudos for talking about the earnings recession potential for 2019. I think he was a little surprised we had such a downdraft in December ahead of his call. But this morning, or yesterday, excuse me, had a call out saying, look, at 2,600 to 2,650, considering lighten up, that's where we are right now. And 2,400, which was where we were back in December in the bottom, he would be an aggressive buyer there. So hedging his bets a little bit. Interesting call from him yesterday. As for the earnings right now, here's where we stand. So far, the Q4 reports, there hasn't been a lot of bad news, although Stanley Black & Decker was definitely a bit of a surprise this morning. So we'll have to keep an eye out for anything more like that. That certainly is not good news. Overall, though, for the first quarter, which is what we care about, downward revisions are occurring, but the market, the quarter is still positive overall. And for 2019, which is what everyone's trying to handicap, we've gone from 10% earnings growth for October 1st to now roughly 5 to 6%. And most of the estimates are aggregating around the 5% level. Right now it's 6%. But the number of people who are at zero or negative is pretty small right now. So bottom line is we're holding up here. Brett's been improving. No 52-week lows out there. We just haven't hit a lot of new 52-week highs. So we're sort of in that middle area right now for the markets trying to recover from December. Right now, Dow's down 143 points.